Right. Well, let's keep it moving, literally, with SunRail, okay?
Right.
Both of you are backers of this commuter rail project.
Yeah.
What we want to know from you is, can we afford it? And if we build it, will they come? More specifically, how will you ensure they will ride it? Let's start with Ms. Jacobs.
Okay. Yes, we do both support it. My opponent has said it's inevitable that it will require an increase in taxes. I don't agree with that. The estimates for how much it's going to cost, we will begin taking responsibility for the operational cost in the year 2020. Now, that seems like a ways out, but I know it'll be here quicker than we think. But it's still far enough out that we can budget and plan for it. And we are talking about a relatively minor amount of money considering the size, the overall size of the county budget, which is about $3 billion. A well-run organization can easily accommodate that. So we do not need to raise taxes to operate SunRail. Will they come? Will they ride it? Yes, I think they will. I think the better predictor, and I saw a great little cartoon the other day. I think it had a train, and on the back it said $4 a gallon gas, and the guy said, boy, it's looking better and better. You know, a big factor in that is, what are the prices of gas? SunRail is a little bit like an insurance policy. You know, today people are going, I don't know, I'd rather drive my car. We have to plan for the future. We have to plan for the day when I may not be able to drive my car and I want an option, when I may not be able to afford the gas. We need to plan for a future when maybe I just want the luxury of being able to commute to work and get on my laptop and work while I'm getting there and work while I'm getting back. We've got to get beyond how we live today and predict and imagine how we're going to live in the future. Every one of us buys insurance, fire insurance for our house. Very few of us expect our house to burn down. In some ways, SunRail is like that. It's an insurance policy. And when you look at the overall cost, it's not very expensive. We will make it work, and the ridership will depend on a lot of factors. But over time, it will be there. I hope it's a success early on, because it should be the first leg in a much more expansive system. Rail works best when you have a complete system.
Mr. Siegel, can we get them all on board?
Absolutely. And Commissioner Jacobs, it might have been Mr. Falconer that said we'd have to raise taxes for SunRail, but it wasn't me. Mm-hmm. I am a huge supporter of SunRail, and I think it's going to change the face of Orange County and really Central Florida. It's going to provide immediate jobs. People say it's only going to support the people that live near it. I was in Winter Garden a few months back and talking to a guy, an engineer that is going to be working on it. It is the beginning of a transportation system that this community needs and deserves. We're going to have transit-oriented development growing up right around those tracks, new opportunities, new ways to grow. And inherent in the SunRail legislation is money for links to have some new feeder routes. So it is just the beginning. It is going to be a huge job provider. And to those people that are expecting it to be an overnight success, it won't be. The naysayers, when it opens the first year or two, are going to say, see, it didn't work. Don't look at it on the short-term proposition. It's going to be a huge success and the beginning of a system that this community needs and deserves.
Ms. Jacobs, 30 seconds.
No rebuttal.
That's fine. Let's move it on.